Emotional independence means I am primarily responsible to take care of my own emotional needs for nourishment, my own sense of self, and my own moods. Does that mean that you cannot depend on anybody? I should not need anybody? No, it doesn't mean that, because we are social animals and relationships can bring us a lot of nourishment, source of joy, and in fact, it can be a big part of our emotional life. However, they can also bring us pain and suffering. And why is that? It's because of emotional dependency. What that means is, if you are letting somebody else's whims and fancies and actions to decide your own sense of self, your own moods and well-being, if you are depending on another person, you are letting that person be in charge. And that is going to bring you suffering. So how do you balance this need for connection, but at the same time, need for being emotionally self-sufficient, independent? I have three tips for you. Listen to these three tips carefully and also try to understand them. If you have any questions, put it in the chat below. Let's talk about it. Because I believe that if you understand deeply what I'm saying, your relational picture or your dependency can be changed almost right away. At least you can begin the journey. So tip number one is the first step towards emotional independency. To get rid of all the expectations you have from other people. Because they don't really owe you anything. Now, this may sound harsh, but wait to listen to tip number two and tip number three to get the antidote to this, what may seem like a harsh thing. But really speaking, when people are nice to us, they bring us nourishment, that's a privilege. It's not our right. But it's the most common source of discontent in relationships. Friendships, spousal relationships, relatives, we expect things from them. We expect them to help us. We expect them to understand our moods and needs. We expect them to call us and check on us and offer us whatever we need, understand our moods. When we are not feeling bad, then to offer us nurturing. When we are feeling like not doing anything, then not to pressure us. We expect to be taken care of by other people, but by doing that, first of all, we are giving them, we are putting them in charge of our moods, but most importantly, to know that it is not our right. A lot of times when we are expecting from other people, and if it doesn't come to us, we feel either that something is wrong with me or something is wrong with other person. Either that I'm a victim or the other person is a bad guy. But more often than not, it's none of that. It's a mismatch between how you're putting out your needs and the other person's capabilities. So the attention and the nurturing that we expect, if we want that to happen, then start at this point of no expectations. And then whatever comes to us, it feels like a source of joy. And let's go to tip two and tip three to actually understand the details of this point of no expectations. Tip number two is, although the first step is to assume that it is not my right that the other people give me nourishment on their own, however, to know that all my needs are real. They are very important and I have a right to have those needs. Not only that, I have a right to get those needs fulfilled, but it is my responsibility to get these needs fulfilled. So it is perfectly okay to ask for help from other people. There may need to be some exploration to know how to ask for help and how to get my needs met, but it is my job to do that. And it is my right to be okay with asking for help. I suggest if you have a Rolodex of people, friends, relatives, or whoever, put them into at least three buckets. Bucket number one is people who you call upon when you have deep emotional needs for empathy and understanding. Bucket number two is when you have physical needs that you want to get met, like maybe you're not feeling well and you want somebody to do some cooking for you, or you are moving and you want someone to help you with that, anything like that. And bucket number three is people who you just want to have a good time with. You want to watch a movie, go for hiking, you want to talk to them, and maybe sometimes even complain about things. But you are not expecting them to be the deep emotional support, because that kind of connection or capability may not be there. So to realize each person's friend's capability and then to know who to go to and for what is the key to getting your own needs met. And let's say one person is not able to respond to your need on that day, move on to the other person. Do not personalize it. It's not a personal insult. We take ourselves too seriously, and that can create a lot of problems, to move on to the other person. Tip number three is to practice certain positive and good values. And I'm going to give you an example of three really effective and great values. And this particular tip, in fact, is going to be the crucial one to get the nourishment you want. So first value is that of gracious gratitude. When someone does anything nice for you, brings you nourishment, joy, or any caring, understand that it's your privilege, and feel and express gratitude. This is not to please other people. This is not because, oh my God, I need you. It's not about that. It's great. It will encourage the person to, in fact, draw more towards you. If you tell the other person, you don't care about me, you just are not there for me, if those are the messages you give to the other person, then that's not going to encourage them to actually get closer to you. But expressing gratitude, and that's why it's so important to start at the point of no expectations. It's my privilege and not my right. The other really important value is what you want from others. Are you giving it to others? Give it to others. If you want a certain type of caring, if you want empathy or attention, are you giving it to others? Your own strengths may be different than the other person's strengths. So you use your strengths and give to other people based on what your own strengths are, and not to immediately expect reciprocation. Guess what? Whatever you're putting out there, whatever good deeds you're putting out there, it's a pool. And it comes back to you as a pool. It's not like you do a nice thing for one person and the same person returns it back in the same way. But when you are putting out caring and empathy in general out in the world, it will come to you. Especially because you are not expecting it, you will notice it. So the third thing is to notice the way it is coming to you, to open to receiving and noticing when people are doing nice things to you. What happens to us is, a lot of times we get so caught up into the things that we are not getting, or the needs that are not being fulfilled, that we stop paying attention to the times when our needs are fulfilled. And to notice that gives us joy. And by the way, gratitude is something that you feel. Many times you may express it, sometimes you may not actually express it, like, oh my God, you were so nice, thank you. But you may hold it in your heart and you may treat the other person that way. So it is to notice when nice things are coming to you. That really is the key. A lot of times we get caught into negativity and to bring us out of that. What comes in our way? Sometimes envy or resentment may come in our way in expressing gratitude or noticing good things. But just to know it as a general principle will help you. And there are other things you can do to take care of the envy and resentment. And you may want to watch my video on my YouTube channel, which is about envy or social comparison. But most importantly, enjoy what's coming to you because you are not expecting it to come to you.